one was January 18th, 2002. Adrian, what does Pepperdine need to do here tonight?
They don't have a large margin of error. And for Coach Marty Wilson, he said, we can't give Shemek Karnowski deep post touches and also cut off transition baskets. So they've got to be able to defend right there inside.
Tournament every single year since he's been head coach, and 1 year as an assistant before that. And they look to be heading there with a vengeance this season as they miss their first field goal of the game. Gonzaga in the dark blue and Pepperdine in the orange. Pepperdine dealing with injuries this season, missing Amadi Udini, projected starter and one of the best all-around defensive players for Marty Wilson's squad. Tore his ACL, only played 6 games before going down with that injury as Williams the block and Nigel Goss tracks down the loose ball.
This is a key to the game for the Zags. They want to play fast. Already they get the ball up with 27 seconds left on the shot clock to get a high possession shot.
Nice floater by Nigel Williams Goss. Adrian, this is a league that has a lot of good scoring point guards and guards. Nigel Williams-Goss is one of them, but because it's such a balanced team, he's not even in the top 10 in scoring for the conference.
Well, they don't need him for that, but he has mastered the game of decision-making. I like what I see with him when he comes down and makes plays like that, throwing it in the post.
Good seal by Shemek Karnowski. He averages 12.6 boards a game.
Already you saw 2 baskets inside the paint. And this is a focused Gonzaga team. They know they're the Goliath. They know they're the heavy favorite. But they come out starting their game from the defense, trying to get transition to the offense.
Nolan Taylor, the big-bodied freshman.
Back basket.
And Karnowski again getting inside. And it's going to be a long night for Pepperdine if they let Shemek Karnowski get position.
Well, you don't have the body type. You look at a man mounting there, 7'1", 300 pounds, and he gets deep post touches. Taylor's 260 pounds, he's 300 pounds.
Fast start for Gonzaga, looking to take over that number one ranking for the first time since March of 2013. Another turnover by the Waves, they get it right back. Elijah Lee with the pickpocket. Here's their leading scorer, Lamon Murray. Offensive rebound and a kick out. Baskets just not falling here for the Waves in the first couple minutes. Matthews transition three, not there. Good effort by the Waves, and Lamon Murray Jr. wants to run it.
You can feel the excitement, the home crowd. Pepperdine wants to have something to celebrate. They know this is a big stage and a big team. They want to put a blemish on that loss column for Gonzaga.
What a statement it would be here on a national stage at home, as Nolan Taylor has missed his first couple field goals, and the Waves are still scoreless.
One thing that's been impressive about Gonzaga, on a missed shot or a make, they're pushing it right there. You're just bulldozing.
And that's been a long time, and has been with this program for 6 seasons, and really trying to turn things around. He told us before this game, if it weren't for injuries, we would be a much more consistent basketball team. It's been an up and down road so far, 6-15, the record. And yet to score here tonight against the number three team in the country.
Yeah, and preseason, Pose had them a lot in top 4 teams, so they're missing a lot of firepower.
Elijah Lee, the freshman out of Houston, gets the first bucket of the game for Pepperdine.
Good decision, pulling up, stopping and popping, under control. His last 7 games, he's done a better job of managing the team as a freshman.
Karnowski's tough. Too easy.
You're going to double team, and ultimately as well, look for him to go to a zone, because you can't give the big fella, Karnowski, a shot 2 feet from the basket.
They've got a freshman on it. How tough is that as a freshman to go up against the fifth-year senior Karnowski?
Well, you don't want to leave the three-point shooters. Matthews has yet to take a shot.
Chris Reyes is at the line. Transfer from Utah. Imagine Coach Few and his team know not to put too much stock in the rankings, because they've been high seeds before. They've never made it to a Final Four.
He said, let's not talk about it till the end of February. So he's lowering expectations. But that's a good start for Reyes. They need him to be an impact player. He can get you 20 and 10.
Eric Rothman, Adrian Branch here with you in Malibu. Good pick and roll inside. Jonathan Williams with the left hand.
Good spacing. That was too soft defensively when Perkins is able to pick him apart on the soft pick and roll. Got to tighten that up. Points in the paint. has been all their scoring right now.
Gonzaga's made five of their first eight field goal attempts.
This is where Lamon Murray loves to come off the screen and roll. He can catch it and elevate. Right there is his bread and butter.
Just bobbled it so didn't get a chance to turn and shoot. Good perimeter defense by the Zags. Jeremy Major, the school's all-time leader in assists, take that shot. Gonzaga still up by six.
That was a classy moment before the game, celebrating Jeremy. Acknowledged before the crowd as the all-time leading scorer.
Alley-oop, Nigel Williams got to the freshman, Zach Collins.
If you see a shot chart right now, everything has been under 15 feet. Pepperdine has got to get resilient and get stingy about guarding their paint.
Perkins with the swipe went out of bounds off two different type seven-footers, as we see the three-pointer there by Josh Perkins to have two different big men, Karnowski and Zach Collins.
I like where you're going with that. You can play different styles, so when they go to half court and they play a team like a Wisconsin or a Virginia, you can grind it out with a battering ram in Karnowski.
Good slip on the inside by redshirt sophomore Ryan Keenan.
And let's see if this will get Pepperdine going defensively.
Gonzaga shooting 70% from the floor, nearly 7 minutes into this first half. Goss goes right around the freshman Elijah Lee.
Well, that's just being 6'3" going against 6'1" inside the paint. But one thing about the Zags, you can't speed them up. They play with so much poise, even on the road in a hostile environment.
11-4 run for Gonzaga, up 17-6. Good ball movement.
Solomon had tremendous success. Blow by
Perkins. Acceleration into the lane, and Perkins has five.
Let's see if Coach Wilson will change up the defense and go zone. Give him a different look.
11-2 run now for the Zags. They made their last five shots. Jeremy Major, he's known for the assists, but he's putting up some quality shots here in the first half.
Speed and quickness. He's missing his backcourt mate, Udini, who went down with Achilles heel and had to play off the ball. Now he's the point guard. But for him to be an all-time leader and still can score, he's been an impressive player.
Collins with 10 on the shot clock, six straight field goals for the Zags.
When you're looking at a team that's comfortable, they're confident, they put the work in, they've been out, and success feels good. So they put the work in mentally, and now you're seeing the result. It's been like low-lying fruit right now with those easy baskets.
Lamont Murray Jr. just hasn't got a great look in this game so far, as Williams Goss has been all over him. So it's been left to Major to handle the backcourt duties, and he turns it over there. Perkins, good head fake, dump off to Collins, and one.
You talk about 16 points in the paint and also 9 points off of four turnovers. So that's the game plan for Mark Few. He wanted to be aggressive and hit Pepperdine first. So far, they've done it.
16-4 run right now for the Zags. No offense to speak of on 3 of 11 shooting for Pepperdine.
Has to get a touch. He's 0-for-3, but he scores so easily. Gonzaga's done a great job of not letting him get inside the paint for the 15-footer.
Jordan Matthews is guarding him right now. Murray Jr., number 30 in orange. Nigel Williams-Goss did a great job on him before he took a seat on the Gonzaga bench. Six on the shot clock. Chris Reyes.
He's effective. Missed that shot, but he's effective. He can score with 2 feet inside the paint.
Williams-Goss actually still in there. He was hiding. Couldn't handle that transition pass. Jeremy Major pulls up for three.
Gonzaga will take that as long as it's not Lamont Murray Jr.
Collins fouled.
This looks in another direction, and they have somebody else outside of a top of three-point line. He's got a body at 7 feet that can carry 250 pounds. Right now he's 230 pounds, soft hands, and he's got a high ceiling.
It's a luxury for Coach Few with Shemek Karnowski only having to play Collins 17 minutes a game as a freshman, kind of ease him into big-time basketball.
when he was in Denver. He can score from four areas on the court. Three-point line, transition, free throw line, and post it up.
The Murray name, of course, very well known here in the Los Angeles area. Murray Jr. here at Pepperdine. His dad, longtime member of the Los Angeles Clippers. Karnowski, double, triple pump, and a finish.
I'm surprised that the Waves have not double-teamed him yet. He's 8 for 8. Usually, if he gets double-teamed, he's looking for a three-point shooter, but he hasn't had to pass it.
On the ESPN app and watch ESPN. The first bucket of the night for the West Coast Conference leading scorer, Lamon Murray Jr.
Wired to score. High percentage shot, elevating over the 7-foot column. That's a good touch.
Coach Marty Wilson says he can score a million different ways.
I'm telling you, he reminds me not so much of his dad, who was wired to score, but also a young Carmelo.
10 on the shot clock. Karnowski fading, tough shot.
Better job bodying up by Taylor, pushing Karnowski out.
Now, West Coast Conference in points per game when really he's the only offensive threat for Pepperdine, so all the defenses are keyed in on him.
Well, I asked him who somebody, this is a tough matchup again, no double team. I asked him who somebody we should keep an eye on, and he lit up smiling saying Chris Reyes. He loves him, wishes he had him for his entire career with his ability to go from the three-point line and also deep post touches. Good pass.
Taylor from top.
That was close.
Almost backcourt violation. On the midcourt line, under 9 minutes to play here in Pepperdine, Nolan Taylor, the freshman from mid-range, rebounded by Matthews.
We just talked about, was that a good shot? Absolutely. The ball was moving. You had Karnowski where you had some space. Just got to knock it down. Shoot it with confidence.
Perkins, the step back. Loose ball tracked down by Allen. A very young Pepperdine team.
You had a young fella with the ball right now. Elijah Lee is a freshman from Houston, and he's growing up on the job.
Jonathan Allen.
There's another freshman.
One of the few seniors gets it into another freshman. There's Lee.
For 40 minutes in one game, not the NBA, a seven-game series. And oh, by the way, keep an eye on Georgetown. That's my sleeper pick as well in the tournament.
All righty. We'll mark it down. We'll see how you're doing at the end of March. Williams Goss, the floater.
Sorry to sound like a broken record, folks, if you're listening out there, but you've got to defend with the urgency.
18 points in the paint for Gonzaga. The entry passes have just been unencumbered. Nolan Taylor, the freshman, he's had some issues.
Also, when you talk about Big Baby Davis, remember he can score, so he's going to continue to look for his offense.
Reset with 8 on the shot clock for Pepperdine. 3 to shoot for Major. Good defense by Perkins.
Challenge shot. That was good defense. Perkins didn't get out of balance where he couldn't contest the shot. Well, this is the first time we're seeing this zone. I like that where you're trying to pack the orange jerseys inside the paint.
Double team Karnowski splits right through it.
He's going to continue to score inside the paint. You don't contest him at the rim.
10 points on 5 of 7 shooting for the senior out of Poland. Good handle by Elijah Lee, but he lost it. Karnowski on the ground. He hasn't had to do a lot of it tonight, but he is a really underrated passer as well as Reyes gets the mid-range.
Yeah, well, you can pick your poison. That's a good shot by Reyes. He can score. But see, when Karnowski gets that deep post touch, you got to put him in the old-fashioned phone booth. Crowd his space.
3-on-2, Major. Little leaner in the lane for Jeremy Major.
Elijah Lee stopped right about it there with the teardrop. And then you saw Major under control. Point guards making good decisions, moving fast on the break.
Williams, good seal underneath, got right inside Lamon Murray Jr.
Off of an assist from Karnowski.
Yep, there you go.
That's what he likes to do as well. He'll pass it to a teammate, and you can play through him. Coaching staff says they love giving him the basketball late in the shot clock because he'll make the right decision. Good drive.
Major with the right hand, a late whistle.
Chris Theory is my Laker. The what-if game. I'm just thinking about Pepperdine right now with all the pieces that they're missing. what if they were at full strength?
Well, Coach Marty Wilson, he talked about it. They would be much more fortified in the backcourt, although it's the front court tonight that's giving them issues, as Shemek Karnowski now with a dozen.
I can imagine the fans for Pepperdine saying, pick on somebody your own size. Well, sorry, there's nobody in the gym his own size right now. But also, you've got to try to get him from catching it so deep. Run at him, make him a passer.
Reyes, blow by Karnowski, good recovery, but a whistle.
But he said on the other side as well, we're going to have a problem with him if he catches it.
Notre Dame at 7 p.m. Eastern. And then we head to Norman for a little bet. Arrow in favor of the Waves here. 5 minutes to play in the opening half. Eric Rothman, Adrian Branch with you in Malibu. Jeremy Major has been persistent driving the basketball tonight. He's taken 7 of the team's 19 field goal attempts. Reyes misses the one-hander. Got his own board in the putback. Good targets by Reyes.
The difference a year makes. He was a role player for Utah last year. I covered him, and he wasn't making the impact. I didn't know he was as explosive, had so much game, but now we're seeing it, and he's a star here for Pepperdine.
Redshirt senior Reyes, as Perkins lost it off of his foot. Transfer from Utah. He spent 2 years there, got his degree in communications, spent 1 year as a freshman at St. Mary's, then transferred out of D1 to Citrus College before finding his way to the Utes, and now his fifth year with Pepperdine. And that's another turnover on the Waves, their eighth.
Now, you don't have Karnowski in, so you've got a better matchup physically in the front line for Pepperdine. You've got to be active.
Perkins, well off the line. Missing short. Lamon Murray Jr. been very quiet. Just 2 points in this game so far, averaging just under 21. Major has been the major story on offense for what little offense the Waves have had here in the first.
He's quick. He can break down a good defender. He's done a good job getting inside the paint.
Perkins weaving inside and a friendly roll off the iron.
A lot of times for many years, the West Coast Conference has been known as a point guard league, and you're seeing excellent guard play. Perkins, 3 for 5, very efficient. Jeremy Major scoring well.
Pick and roll, Reyes. Good feet underneath. Second effort not there for Lassen. And a loose ball whistle. 12 points, Collins with 8. They've combined to shoot 9 for 12 from the floor.
Good focus as well. Coming out, remember, they're the heavy favorites, but they're still taking high percentage shots inside the paint again. That's going to be 28 to 12. Pepperdine's offense isn't too bad. They've been missing makeable shots, but the story of the game right now is on the defensive end.
First bucket of the night for Jordan Matthews. Gonzaga practiced today at his alma mater, Santa Monica High School. He was happy to be come out to the real people in Santa Monica.
I was called for city, flop box heels ball. I was a young fella, 23.
Under 2.5 minutes to play here in the first half.
Keep an eye on Matthews at the three-point line. That's a good matchup. Can't lose track of the shooters, Perkins and then Matthews.
Five on the shot clock. Perkins, no look. Was a little bit behind Matthews with 1 on the shot clock. Rebound by Pepperdine.
Good hesitation. Good hesitation. Freeing up a shooter. That's a good play by Lee.
Elijah Lee, the freshman from Houston, actually homeschooled in Houston. Was a runner-up for top homeschool player of the year as a senior.
I didn't know they had that award.
Yes, it's the Pete Maravich Award, which I looked up and Maravich was not homeschooled, so I'm not exactly sure why he's the namesake of that award.
My daughter's homeschooled, so I got to consider that when she doesn't play basketball. That's a challenge.
Elijah Lee.
Hitch didn't like that shot because he was out of rhythm, took himself out of rhythm on that pump fake.
Two and a half minutes since Pepperdine last scored. Gonzaga shooting 64% from the floor. After us, Iowa, Maryland, Oklahoma, Baylor on Sunday.
of the similar skill level, like Arizona. They come out the same way. I like what I see with them.
They'll be a one seed on their own this season, but they need the...
In 3 seconds. So they'll take an opportunity, but because they're so smart and unflappable, they take the best shot and wear defense down. But they do like to play fast. They just don't take fast shots.
Right.
Well, we talked about that stat, 36 seconds left. Mark Few, 18 NCAA.
Presented by Straight Talk Wireless at 3 and also streaming live on the ESPN app and Watch ESPN. Final 20 seconds here in the first half. Gonzaga has not trailed a basketball game in what now will be 10 straight halves. One on the shot clock for Perkins and a putback for Silas Nelson. The exclamation point on a dominant first half performance on the road against Pepperdine. And Collins is so difficult, especially for an undersized team like Pepperdine.
Yeah, you can't cut everything off. I like the preparation that you have with Gonzaga. They're serious-minded. They respect the opposition, and they're back to work again, points in the paint.
Jonathan Williams, that two-handed flush to start things off here in the second half. And last time Gonzaga was number one in the country, March 4th, 2013. They would love to be atop the polls. The start of next week with teams like Villanova, Kansas, Kentucky, Florida State, all picking up losses this week, although Kansas on the road against Kentucky.
That was an impressive one.
Maybe you could argue they're going to be at number one. Could be a 1-2 Kansas-Gonzaga. Flip-flop them either way, I think you'd be right on the money. Tough shot for Nolan Taylor as the shot clock expires and it's a violation.
Exactly.
It just seems like everybody's a role player on this team.
Well, that's true. That's true. Seven players averaging over 8 points. No one strains the offense. They play well. They have chemistry, maturity. This is a solid team.
Matthews fading away. What I like about this team is offensive rebound for Karnowski and the kick out to Perkins. Loose ball tracked down by Elijah Lee.
Nice handle in traffic.
Murray Jr., a quiet first half for him, just 4 points. Gets the first field goal of the half for Pepperdine. Williams Goss trying to silence the crowd. And Lee gets bumped. 21 points per game this season, just 6 so far here, nearly 2 minutes in to the second half.
When you've got the ultimate green light, he doesn't take a lot of bad shots. He can make that. Oh, where has that been in the first half?
Pepperdine would love for him to catch fire here in the second. 3 of 8 shooting for Murray, and now a foul on the inside.
It's a soft touch, like his dad.
Matthews, count it. And the foul, Jordan Matthews. On Gonzaga to have double-doubles this season. For as good as they are offensively and on the interior, you would think that there would be more double-doubles, but they're just so balanced.
Well, they do their work early, and a lot of times because they have a 25-point scoring margin, they're sitting down so you don't accumulate stats. But again, it's workmanlike. We saw them in shoot-around. That's a good shot by Reyes.
Offensive rebound and a touch put back by Lamont Murray Jr. 6 in the second half for Murray.
Lamont is so unselfish. He doesn't force his offense. He was 1 for 6 in the first half, but now he's come off with a fast start with 6 quick baskets.
Pick and roll. Good head fake by Karnowski. The big man puts it on the deck.
Did I just see what I just saw? A 300, 7'1", 300 pounder with the soft touch and soft feet.
Pirouetting on the baseline. He's been taking ballet in the offseason. Murray fading to his right. Tough shot. What the ball handling ability of Elijah Lee to get that ball to Murray on the catch and release. Matthews short on the 3. Perkins offensive rebound.
First time we've seen Shimmick in a high screen and roll. Usually he's on the lower block.
Matthews weaving. Hammered inside.
He's a mountain of a man.
Well, nowadays it would be Game of Thrones.
I know what the name is. Oh.
Yeah,
you can citizen, yeah.
You know why I say it? Because you can't hit me on live TV. What happens after the game now, I don't know.
Good ball movement. Solid ball movement.
Inside the Keenan and a turnover. Turnovers have been an issue. Number 9 on the night for Pepperdine.
Coming back with the same ball movement. Nobody fatiguing the offense. Still 18 seconds left on the shot clock because they get the ball up in 3 seconds.
Williams with the left hand. Karnowski, offensive rebound. Missed the gimme. Murray Jr. falling to the floor. Wanted a whistle, didn't get it. Gonzaga not slowing the pace. Lee went for the steal. Matthews now for the three. And frantic pace up and down here. The last two possessions is Gonzaga 52. You played basketball down in Australia for a while. Did you get out and play some tennis while you were down there?
No, you know what? We played the games at the tennis court because it's during, you know, right now the Australian Open. Mm-hmm. And the summer's flipped. It's summertime down there right now when it's the part of winter for us up here. Didn't know that, did you? Stick with me after Jeopardy. You're
right.
Going places,
young
man.
You're getting your tidbits.
Going places.
Eric Rothman, Adrian Branch here with you in Malibu. Jeremy Major airmailing that three. Gonzaga on top, 52-27. They are 21-0 on the year. The only undefeated team remaining in college basketball. And an argument can be made that next week they should be ranked number one. We will see if the AP voters agree. Still some good teams in that top five.
We're going to put our best foot forward. They have some pockets of doing positive things. They share the basketball. Majors is legit.
The basketball, the wave 6-15 this season, really decimated by injuries.
Oh, yeah, that's been the story of Pepperdine. And we asked Coach Wilson, what have you learned about yourself? Because he's built on toughness. He's a former point guard here. Toughness and rebounding, and he said, I learned patience.
Yep.
I've learned patience about myself.
Injury is one of the things that coach cannot control. Williams Goss using that left shoulder to lean in on Jonathan Allen for the bucket.
He has impressed me with his ability to read the defense. Nigel Williams Goss has mastered the game of college basketball at the college level with his ability, knowing when to call his number and when to set up a teammate.
Williams Goss, 8 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists tonight. As Lamon Murray Jr., just 4 points in the first half, now 8 here in the second.
Lots of love about Lamon Murray. Does not take bad shots for a leading scoring conference.
Silas Melson, the three-pointer for the junior out of Portland.
Melson playing with so much confidence. He's not in competition with Perkins. He's not in competition with his teammates. He lives in the moment, takes the challenge. Now he's defending the best score in conference, doing the dirty work.
9-2 run for Gonzaga. These two teams have combined to shoot just 2 of 20 from three-point range. Make it 2 of 21. Pepperdine has yet to make a three-point bucket. And it's surprising, at least on Gonzaga's end, because Pepperdine is one of the worst teams in the nation in terms of three-point defense. Gonzaga not able to score on the perimeter so much tonight, but it's been the interior play, the points in the paint. Everything has
knocked down the shot, shooting with confidence. It's just from the flow of the offense.
Melson, floater in the lane, 5 straight for Silas Melson.
You've seen Perkins make that shot. You've seen Williams Goss make that shot. Picked up the basket, lady. Didn't see the basket.
Perkins has to save it on the baseline. Bobbled around and out of bounds. We'll stay.
I say, man, he didn't even see the rim and made him.
Heck of a career for not seeing the basket every time he shot. Pick and roll. Collins, a two-hand slam. Pick and roll has been there all night for Gonzaga, Adrian.
The floor spacing, the pace.
Efficient this entire season.
He's putting himself right now, the screen and roll. They're in first place in the Big Ten. Please, give him some respect.
And also, for college basketball fans, very disappointing about Mo Watson's injury as well for Creighton, because one of the best decision makers in the country. Leader in assists in the NCAA. Reyes gets the bucket, but Nigel Williams-Goss, you've talked about it before, and you were talking to Coach Few about it today. It's the decision-making, it's the leadership, which is impressive because this is only season with the team.
Well, he wants to do two things. He wants to win, but he wants to be an All-American on the court and also a psychology major, 3.8. He went right here calling his number. He wants to be an All-American, academic All-American.
He's already graduated. He's got his degree. He's going for his master's now. Putting on a clinic here tonight, 10 points on 5 of 8 shooting.
Well, Coach Few says he tries to mark every category, assists, rebounds. He has a clock inside of his head, and he's always talking. So that's one position Coach Few doesn't have to coach.
Reyes, the baby hook swatted by Collins.
That's an excellent job by Collins defending without fouling.
Perkins, no look. And Karnowski with the left.
Shemek Karnowski running the floor, catching the easy basket. He's got soft hands.
Good idea with
41 in the W.
Matthews and his brother Jonah is now a freshman at USC and playing very well and entering into the starting lineup for the Trojans as a freshman. Both played at Santa Monica High School for the Vikings. Matthews tonight with 7 points as Pepperdine off the turnover, missing the runner by Knox Hellums.
First time we're seeing Knox in the game.
Zach Collins
out with Shemek Karnowski. We're seeing the open flow, the alley-oop dunks. Nigel Williams-Goss controlling the game. Here he is again.
The defensive end this time, spinning and finding the vision at the front of the hoop.
This team has everything clicking. It's a hungry team. It's aware of its responsibility, and they've shown themselves well coming out dominating. The points in the paint has fatigued the Waves right now in this game.
Gonzaga has made their last 8 field goal attempts. It's been over 2 minutes since Pepperdine got their last bucket. Knox Hellums changes that, the freshman from Texas.
There's few clips that you would keep.
Basketball now, his first appearance in tonight's ball game.
NBA scouts love Rui. This young man from Japan, 6'8", explosive, is gonna be one of the next stars in line as he continues to develop.
Jonathan Williams, the turnaround for his 8th point.
Good call. Matthews fouled him on the wrist.
He didn't speak any English.
From Beyonce or some of the movies or something like that. So I'm impressed that he came on over. But nice proportion. 6'8", about 220 pounds. Explosive, long arms, soft touch. Keep an eye on this young guy.
Just the 5th Japanese-born player in the history of Division I basketball. Nelson head down, double team, flips it to Williams. Hachimura tips it in.
You can't teach that. He's got a natural knack for the ball, a sense of timing, explosive leaper. Again, I was hit with the same scouts that were looking at Zach Collins and saying Hachimura and Zach Collins are the best NBA prospects on the team.
Hachimura today at practice was kind of mumbling on defense, and his teammates were yelling at him, telling him to speak up, and he spoke up, said a complete sentence in perfect English, and got a standing ovation from his teammates at Santa Monica High School at shoot-around today.
I like it. I like it. This is where the ball movement. Albers, good shot.
Albers,
nothing's forced.
Redshirt sophomore just around the corner, Northridge. And a Euro step by Lee, rejected by Hachimura. Up ahead, Nelson. A block on the other end by
first round draft pick. So this is a history of where
Gonzaga with a win tonight would be the longest winning streak in school history. 22 wins in a row.
You're seeing the chemistry. The shoot around was there. Strong drive by Reyes. Excellent drive. With Rui. And then he explodes up.
Reyes top 10 in the West Coast Conference in points, rebounds, blocks, and field goal percentage per game. Very efficient in what will be his only season with the Waves as a graduate transfer. Firestone Fieldhouse. Good crowd, even though the kids are still on winter break. He was when he showed up to training camp and how fit he was and how he fits into this Gonzaga scheme. They just couldn't find a way to sit him out for the year.
Yeah, he's got talent. You can't deny his explosiveness. He challenges shots at the rim. He can be off base and still contest the shot.
Monday game at 7 Eastern, then we head to Norman as Oklahoma State.
That Duke win, that was an incredible win for him. They had a meeting at Coach K's house, and they said, get out the practice court, take off the jerseys. And so this might jumpstart the second half of their season going into February.
Silas Nelson, you saw the graphic, just 2 3-pointers for Pep Gonzaga as a team. As Nelson gets the third one there, he's got 2 of the team's 3. Rejection underneath Jeremy Jones, the redshirt sophomore, getting some playing time. And Jones tipping in the missed shot by Alberts.
Well, they can do no wrong on both ends of the floor. That was the second time we've seen a block shot trigger fast break. Rui Hachimura did it earlier. And then you just saw again the Collins blocking shots and getting them running out. There's another block.
Up ahead to Nelson.
Poor shot. That's the kind of getting yours.
Heat check Silas Nelson.
Yeah, I've been there myself.
Three for three from three tonight.
I've been there myself. Kind of break off the play and go ahead. Tremendous success. Hall of Fame would say the harder you work, the luckier you get. John Witten would say chance favors the prepared. They're prepared.
You and I will be in Provo on Thursday as Gonzaga takes on BYU in BYU. Do you think that that's a potential loss? That's a tough environment to play in on the road if you're Gonzaga.
Well, let's go back with this one. It should be a more competitive game, a lot more competitive. You've got Eric Mika, who's positioning himself possibly as a player of the year candidate, over 20 points and double-doubles. And they're an older group as well. You've got freshmen out here for Pepperdine trying to figure it out. A lot of players from BYU go on their two-year Mormon mission
right.
and come back and have experience. So this will be a lot.
In Northern California on the 11th, and they finish the season off at home against BYU. And this is a team that in the past 10 days, because of scheduling due to a snowstorm in the game against Portland, they've played five games in 10 days. Gonzaga not showing any signs of being tired here tonight.
It was a veteran group. They didn't do a lot of running at shoot-around. It was more walking and technical. They're in mid-season form right now. You've got a lot of games, and Coach Few can trust them. He can trust Shemek Karnowski. You know what you're going to get from Nelson. You know what you're going to get from Williams Goss.
Brian Alberts, the finger roll, and in a win like this too, Adrian, and in a lead like this, they can rest their starters like they're doing now.
When I was with the Lakers, 1987, I was a rookie, and there were some games I knew that was going to be a blowout. At the time, Sacramento and Denver, I was getting my rest the night before because I knew I was going to play the whole fourth quarter. And a lot of things, Gonzaga had control of this game. I don't think they trailed at all in this game.
They have not, and they have not trailed
for the last, what?
10 and a half halves.
There
so
we
that's
go.
Five full games, plus another half if they win out here. I would assume that Gonzaga is not going to give up a 50-point lead here in the final 4 minutes.
And that means it's workmanlike. They come out, they take it seriously. The first time I ever heard this was from Pat Riley, the block.
And more of the goal tell. Well, they shouldn't because of the conference that they play in. Maybe not one of the best conferences as a mid-major. What do you say to that as you're yawning?
Wake me up. They said that with John Calipari, with Derrick Rose. Remember, they would wear out their conference, and they weren't a Power 5 conference at the time. Jameer Nelson, as we mentioned earlier, as well, back in 04. So they're doing their work. They put themselves in a position to be recognized as the number one team in the nation in my book.
Nolan Taylor, the turnaround. Gonzaga tonight, 50 points from their starters, 44 points from their bench.
Then we talk about the Mark Few factor as well. This team has been unprecedented where they went, as you mentioned, coming out of halftime, unprecedented, 10-0 in non-conference. That was a surprise to me, though, with all those good teams that he's had over the years.
First time his teams have gone undefeated in non-conference, and now what will be the longest winning streak in program history with a win tonight.
If you look at what Pepperdine can take from this, one, you've got experience. So those freshmen, Taylor, I like what I see in Lee, the point guard. They're getting some experience. Now, you're taking your lumps. You're taking your lumps, but they've got a foundation that this West Coast Conference is unforgiving. If you're not a fool to believe, 2 to 3 more times.
They already got one win.
The return, they got to go to
see. What's the game you want to see?
I want to see Gonzaga and UCLA. I want to see half of that. I want to see Nigel Williams-Goss going against Lonzo Ball and everything else. Out here on the West Coast, they represent their conferences. They represent the game of basketball well.
Under 2 minutes to play here in Pepperdine.
You're going to get that a few more times. UCLA and Arizona a few more times.
Oh, absolutely. And I can't wait. I can't can't wait to see what Gonzaga does the remainder of this season. Can they stay undefeated on the road against BYU and St. Mary's? Two tough tasks ahead for the Zags.
Still playing hard, a minute 24, but I
will be Gonzaga's 19th straight trip to the NCAA tournament.
Interesting thing, again, finishing up, they look like they're going to win. I never like to say it until it's over. I really don't. But it's not like they're too high or too low. Emotionally, they came in here with a balanced, workmanlike performance, and then as they leave in a nice, warm, intimate setting, they're going to go out there and not be emotionally taxed as well.
The question is nationally, will they be number one? Last time Gonzaga was number one, March 4th, 2013. I'm thinking it's going to come down to Kansas and Gonzaga in the rankings coming out as Edwards the SWAT. Everybody on Gonzaga's bench getting into the action tonight.
That's the eighth block in this game, and all of them have been timely.
Under 30 seconds to play.
Ew. Turn around.
Mark Few, what a job he's done. 22-0 for his team. And they are confident, they are collected, and it looks like they are poised to continue this streak as long as they're playing.